If you take a step back for a moment, you really have to look at it over the last couple of decades. China's been through an agricultural revolution that started in the 70s with agricultural reform, and then it transitioned into a manufacturing reform. Over that time period, the transformation is phenomenal. 600 million people moved out of poverty. Now it's the beginning, really, of a new transformation, which is led by the consumer and the private sector. China, in some respects, is leapfrogging the rest of the world as they adopt technology and all the tools that are available to them. Take WeChat. It's an instant messaging service, but you can do pretty much anything on it, from share a message to pay for movie tickets. And there are close to a billion people on WeChat. One of our clients explained that he hasn't actually opened his wallet in 4 months. He's living purely off his phone. That means small transactions to actually managing larger, more complex aspects of his life, literally on his phone. China is digitizing. Really, you could argue much faster than we are in the West, and this is just one example. The thing that I'm really left with every time I'm there is the level of energy and the entrepreneurship that exists in China. 1 in 3 unicorns now comes from China. And when we're meeting with our clients, whether it's a travel services entrepreneur, someone that just created an online drugstore, someone focused on building out retail, the energy and the transformation, it's just amazing. And the way these entrepreneurs are thinking about their own growth and strategies for growth, it's all wrapped up in this 6.9% giant economy growing. Obviously, goes without saying, it's not easy to grow a $10 trillion economy. There are gonna be challenges. It's complex, and at times it's gonna be difficult, and for sure, it's not gonna be a straight line between here and there. Now, having said that, when you talk to people on the ground in China, they're very thoughtful about the considerations and they understand the complexity. And they also understand that they're gonna have to continue the reform agenda. But this transformation in this next phase where they grow the private sector and do things like open their capital markets, it's just extraordinary. And what you feel really is it's the pace of change.